NFL 23. And we'll see Fred Warner, who really led his defense last.
Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, week 7 is underway on EA Sports. Taking it about the 1. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They'll be led out by a former Pro Bowl quarterback out of the University of Georgia, Matthew Stafford. On first down, they'll start out with Akers. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They'll take that 14 yards on play number 1. That's a good acceleration there as he's across midfield to the 40-yard line. It's a Rams first down on a pickup of 10. And the Rams sitting at a very solid 4-2 record through the first 6 weeks. They come in playing pretty good football, winners of 4 of their last 6 games.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. And the last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They'll go again here with Akers. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Now Stafford. Open man is Atwell, complete. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. Interesting decision here. Opening drive, Charles, 4th and short. You're in field goal range. We'll see what they do.
I just shake a fist at my offense and say, go get it, guys, because if you can't pick up 4th and short here, we're probably in trouble the rest of the game. Show some confidence. Show some aggressiveness. Go pick it up.
They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. So they convert on 4th, and now from just outside the 30, here's 1st and 10. Stafford going to give this to Akers. They find some open field here. Touchdown,
LA! Throughout the game, we're going to track so many different statistics, but one is becoming increasingly in vogue. Explosive runs, runs of 20 yards or more, and we just saw one right there to open this game.
Now we'll see how the other team responds, because when you get a play like that against you this early in the game, you got to feel like your back's against the wall a little bit.
Yeah, the pressure now increases on you because your first thought is we have to answer right now.
Cody Parkey is on now for the point after. It's up, it's good. Now after the score, it's Parkey on to kick it away. Here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him 3 more. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. They'll be led out by the former number 3 overall pick back in 2021. It's Trey Lance. Lance and the 49ers now, 1st and 10. At their own 28-yard line. Now a play fake. Lance. Blitz coming and down he goes. Terrell Lewis coming in from that outside linebacker spot, and he buries him for a loss of 7. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a 2nd down and 17. A first carry for Elijah Mitchell. So from 2nd and 1, now we go to 3rd and very manageable.
Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing, because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in 4-down territory, that really opens things up for you.
On third and short. They'll try option one. A strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. Really good effort. He does it himself, picks up 15, also picks up the first down.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. And now the Rams have got it, going the other way. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football. And they still find ways to knock it free.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Going right back to Akers. And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. 75 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start. They'll run on first down with Akers. And he'll be brought down just outside of the 30. 3 yards remain for second down. They'll go with Akers here up the middle. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Rams with the football here to begin the second quarter. Heavy set out there on third and one. They'll try and run for this with Akers. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27.
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient on picking up third downs in the top five in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I guarantee you, it started in the offseason. Third downs important to them. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. They give up the middle to Akers. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
He'll get this one complete to Atwell. And he'll be stopped here well short of the first down at the 24-yard line. Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. The kick by Parkey is good. Start at the 25. Back out there comes the 49ers offense ready for their second drive. And they are back down to 500 following the loss last week. Consistency has been a real issue for them so far.
Brandon, you almost don't know what team is going to show up every week. I mean, there's no consistency with this ball club at all. And if we feel that way, I know it frustrates the coaching staff. And it also has to frustrate the key leaders in the locker room. They got to figure out how to get coordinated.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Lance to throw. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes.
Defense is worried that whenever anyone catches the ball, has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half, 10-0. Our score. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing his lance on third down. That's into the crowd and intercepted. And the Rams are going to get it back here just past the 35. But that one was in the air for an agonizingly long time.
Just begging to be picked off, wasn't it? It's one thing if you're throwing a ball like that, trying to throw someone open and lead them into an area. But that ball needed to be thrown with a lot more conviction. As a result, it's an easy interception.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. On a handoff, it's Akers. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5. Give, this is Akers, and I don't think he got there. No, he's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it 4th and inches. Here we go on 4th. Stafford, and it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Niners take over in terrific field position. First down, here's Mitchell. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain. 2nd down. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. From the 44, Lance. Here's Mitchell with a catch out of the backfield. And he's got this down a yard or 2 shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Lance looking to throw it. This one to the sideline. He's got it. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for 3, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3.
So that kick gives them their first points of the game, CD. And it comes on the 3rd drive, but hopefully for them that's a spark that gets that offense going.
Yeah, and I would say if you're the offensive play caller, as you look at your sheet, you're trying to find that part on there that unlocks bigger points. They've struggled with a few drives so far. Finally got 3 out of it. How do you find the end zone? That's what he's searching for now.
They'll begin on the ground with Akers. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. 104 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half. And he will find Atwell. That's complete. And he is going to have a Rams first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 1. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
From there, we're off to check out another game. And they were losers in that one.
The second half upon us sooner than we bargained for. Week 7, second half, let's do it. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. The 49ers going to have the football and trailing on the scoreboard as we get back underway on EA Sports. From a yard or 2 deep, here comes a return. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The 49er offense set to go to begin quarter number 3. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here
in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
They'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts, because he definitely needs some assistance.
And they'll run the option on third and short yardage.
Yeah, this is only going to be a gain of two. He needed three. It's fourth and one.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
A 40-yard punt, no return. And Rams back offense here for the first and 10.
So here are the Rams to take over. They were 7-point winners a week ago, and they lead by 7 here as well as they start out first and 10. Stanford looking middle, and that's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. To throw again on second down. Stanford, and that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. On third down, here's a run by Akers. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. On the ground, it's Akers. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Here's Akers, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
And in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
Throwing on third down, Stanford. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Picked off by Fred Warner, and the 49ers are going to take possession of the football.
Well, he had the football into a pretty tight window over the middle. And, Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes the quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man. Sometimes you're fooled by the type of zone that he sees, because oftentimes those linebackers will vacate and run downfield with receivers. In this case, he played a pure zone and was in the wrong spot for the QB. But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They run over center with Mitchell. Shifts volume. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Right? Another run with Mitchell. And here he'll get it down to the 7. That leads us to a first and goal. It's a pickup of 8.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive they went 3 and out.
They'll run with Mitchell. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Elijah Mitchell, his second rushing touchdown of the year. And the 49ers have a chance to tie the ball game here in the final minute of the third.
They go I formation, fullback leads the way for the touchdown. Sort of a lost start, isn't it?
It really is, but sometimes when you're able to bring it back and use it against other teams, they're not prepared for it. They haven't seen it in a while, and now you gain an advantage, and we just saw that advantage result in the touchdown.
Pinheiro's extra point up and good.
And we are even at 10 apiece.
All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. From the end zone, here comes Williams.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
L.A. readies for its next possession. They had the interception on the last drive, which led to the tying touchdown. So 10-10 the score as they begin first and 10. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. Operating from the 27 now. Here's 2nd and 3. Now a run with Akers. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. Back now here on EA Sports. Knotted up here at 10. That's our score as we begin quarter number 4. Stafford. To the right side and complete to Atwell. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be 4th and inches. They snap it to Stafford. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on 4th down. And that will force a turnover on downs. And they'll begin by running the option. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down. On 2nd down, here's Mitchell. And room there to work it inside the 25. 48 yards on the ground for him so far. The offense on 3rd down tonight. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 4. Now Lance. And it's Kittle. And they'll get this down to the 10. Lance and Kittle in sync for the 49er first. Lance now to throw. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
A handoff from Mitchell running left. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Elijah Mitchell, his 2nd touchdown of the night. And the Niners have broken our tie and have taken a 4th quarter lead. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that makes it a 17-10 score. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. Fielded just outside the goal line. Lane opens here. He's past the 30. And he'll get to the 30-yard line before going out of bounds. The offense for Los Angeles returns to the field. The pressure is on now. They're being shut out here in the 2nd half after a decent 1st half offensively. And they need their best drive of the game right here. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5. Throwing again on 2nd down. Stafford. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this 2nd half. Here's 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Stafford. And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Well, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's 2nd down. Ball on the 42 as they come up 2nd and 10. There's Stafford. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line. The battle in the trenches never more important than right now. This is 3rd and inches. Right back to Atwell, that's complete. And he is going to have a Rams 1st down as that'll be a pickup of about 5 as they convert on 3rd and inches. Stafford. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 20. Ahead of the chains now, 2nd and 2. Now Stafford. And a comeback May stall out. It's intercepted. Picked off by Fred Warner. And the Niners have just about sewn up this football game.
Ready.
Here's Mitchell now to kick off the drive. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. Lance going to hold on to it. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Backed up here. Tough spot. Needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Here's Lance. Flush to his right. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down. Here comes the 49ers punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. A 46-yard punt, 4-yard return. And they will take over first and 10. So now Stafford and the Rams trailing 17-10, 30 seconds to go. Stafford now to throw. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down. Now it's Stafford. He's got Atwell. That's complete. And he'll have a quick first down here as he gets out of bounds to stop the clock. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Back to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. That'll be caught. It's caught. And he is across and in for the score. And now they can tie the game in the final stages with an extra point.
Or they can go for two and go for the win.
One last throw here for Stafford. It's complete. And he is into the end zone. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he takes this near the 20. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going. Yeah, the effort, that was good. Very good, in fact. They were just a little too far out to get a decent look at the end zone for that last opportunity. Couldn't get it done, but a nice game overall.
So for LA, the win moves them up to 5-2 now on the year.